फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू youtube.com/DrVed चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी विल सी इम्पॉर्टेंट बैक्टीरियल डिसीज दैट इज कॉमनली अकरिंग एक्टिनोमाइकोसिस। इन पार्ट वन वी विल डिस्कस synonyms and related terms, introduction, etiology and epidemiology of actinomycosis. Friends, actinomycosis produces various types of infection. The common infection and its type is, it produces a chronic, means long duration, suppurative, pus formation and granulomatous lesions, just like a granuloma or tumor-like. We'll see the synonyms. One disease that is very commonly occurring in cattle, it is lumpy jaw. Lumping is a swelling on the jaw. It is a chronic long duration, progressive slowly developing, indurated hard mass, granulomatous, containing suppurative abscesses, abscesses containing pus, and mostly seen in mandible and maxilla in cattle. This is most common. The actinomycosis also causes infection in horses called fistulous withers and poor living. It is also long duration, chronic, suppurative, granulomatous lesion of bursa in the horse. That detail we will see in the subsequent presentation. Actinomycosis also produces various type of infection in other animals. Mastitis in pig. There is extensive granulomatous lesion of the skin over the udder. In dog, it produces very chronic pyogranulomatous lesion. Granulomatous lesion along with the pus on the skin of submandibular, abdomen and the thoracic region. These are the common infection observed into the domestic animals. In this presentation, we will understand what is actinomycosis. It is a chronic infectious disease. Everywhere in all animals, mostly it produces chronic infection. The disease generally do not occur in an endemic form or epidemic form, but disease occur as a sporadic form. A scattered cases are occurring. Actinomycosis primarily affect cattle and secondarily pigs and horses. Actinomycosis is caused by organism Actinomyces bovis, and this infection is characterized by suppurative granulomatous lesion. Remember this, suppurative granulomatous lesion, granuloma type of the growth and pus formation. Continue with the introduction. In cattle, the primarily affected and it causes lumpy jaw. It is a rarefying osteomyelitis, inflammation of osteomyelitis of bone of skull, and it is rarefied. It is just like a moth eater, very common. Pigs are also sometimes infected. In pigs, there is tumor-like enlargement of mammary gland, mastitis. Horse also rarely affected. In this, there is an inflammation of the bursa of ligamentum nuci. Ligamentum nuci is on the upper part of the neck. The infection is in association with Brucella abortus, both actinomycosis bovis and Brucella abortus both causes infection, and it is named as fistulous withers, fistula at the wither, and a chronic pole evil, a pus formation at the pore. Detail we see in the next presentation. Coming to the etiology of actinomycosis, it is caused by Actinomyces bovis. It is fungus-like bacteria. It is bacteria, but just like fungus. Both morphology and cultural similarity of both bacteria and fungus. The morphology is, the organisms are long filamentous rods, just like fungi, and cocci, just like bacteria, that is found in exudate from active lesions of the animals. Continuing with the etiology portion, Actinomyces bovis is associated with pus-forming organism Corynebacterium pyogenes and Staphylococcus mostly, and with the help of this pus-forming organism, they produce a suppurative lesion. The fistulous withers and pole evil rarely occur in horses. It is caused by Actinomyces bovis with Brucella abortus. Remember, important. Actinomycosis is rarely causes actinomycosis in human beings. So human being was also affected. Most common infection occur in cattle. The next, pig and horse. We discuss here the epidemiology, prevalence of infection of actinomycosis. Disease is worldwide in distribution. In all countries it is found. Disease is also recorded from various regions in India. So it is present in India also. The incidence is higher when the animal consume straw and silage feed, especially cattle. This straw and silage feed are a very coarse material, and while chewing this material, while masticating, it causes injury to the buccal mucosa. And from this injury, the organism that is residing in the buccal cavity, Actinomyces bovis, enter into the bone. The disease generally occur in a sporadic form. A scattered cases, irregular prevalence is observed. Continue with the predisposing factors. The entry of organism and transmission of Actinomyces bovis occurred through injury to buccal mucosa. Remember, its entry to maxilla and mandible is through injury to the oral mucosa. The straw and hard feed contain fibrous coarse material. While masticating or chewing, they may cause injury to the buccal mucosa, and the A. bovis that is normally present in the mouth cavity, oral cavity, enter into the maxilla and mandible. The eruption of permanent teeth in young animals. While erupting, there is injury to the buccal mucosa. And a normal inhabitant of Actinomycus bovis enter into the maxilla and mandible. Any physical hard material in the mouth, wire, stone, glass, any hard material may cause injury to the buccal mucosa and entry of normal inhabitant Actinomycus bovis organism. The oral infection by other organisms also occur, and they are the first producer. We discuss here the source of infection. You know that the domestic animals are affected by many organisms, viral, bacterial, fungal, and they produce stomatitis, especially vesicular and erosive stomatitis. They cause injury to the mouth, and that is stress on the buccal mucosa also. And this predispose the animal for actinomycosis. If actinomycosis infected animal is there, it transmit infection to the other animal through discharge. And when the discharge is fall on the grazing pasture, if the animal, other animal graze on such pasture, the grazing infected pasture may also transmit disease to the normal animal. Friends, I have discussed here some of the conditions caused by actinomycosis in cattle, pig and horses. What is the introduction? We understood the disease in a short. Etiological aspect also covered here. Please share this information to veterinary friends and request you to subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video. Thanks.